Okay, before we begin, I'd like to issue a trigger warning for sexual content. Hi, I'm Sia Obama. I'm a junior.
I'm Rebecca Onken. I'm a senior.
I'm Rebecca Hunter. I'm a senior.
I'm Katie Minoki. I'm a senior, and we're from Westside High School. And the title of our piece is Not Safe for School.
Your virginity is a gift. You don't have to wait until marriage. Your body is a temple. You have to let in someone special.
46% of teens say they've had sex.
Our freshman year, our English class had us write about things and being the problem.
More than half of our class wrote about the lack of comprehensive sex ed in our school.
Only 20 states require medically accurate information to be taught about sex.
Nebraska? Not being one of them. And not stupid.
I'm 18, a legal adult in most states, and you're trying to tell me that my virginity is a gift? Why do you sit there and pretend like condoms?
And you consistently correctly.
Our contraceptive barrier method to protect against STIs and pregnancy.
We tell parents who knows what a dental dam is. Or an IUD, and the fact that it lasts up to 6 years, or that with these types of birth control,
less than one
person will get pregnant a year. You never taught me how to be sick. You never taught me how to respect my body,
how to let others respect my body.
Who is supposed to teach you?
My parents did.
Because they never learned about it in the first place, and this isn't something new. Parents have never known what to tell their children or what to tiptoe around. They've never had the knowledge to start the conversation.
My teachers couldn't.
Because it wasn't an approved curriculum. Because they don't hand out tests with the words vagina, homosexual. Because it goes against their values.
My school board wouldn't.
Because they care more about parents' feelings than the facts. Because satisfying them is easier than fighting for what's right.
They tell us that learning is our top priority.
But I guess that teaching about a biological, completely normal act isn't high enough on their to-do list, because learning about it is going to make me want to do it, right? Well, with that logic, by learning algebra, I'm going to have to want to do math. I'm going to have to impulsively, irrationally do math
with no fear or hesitation.
Because calculus is something I'm going to need in the real world, not sex. Not like coping is something humans do. You want kids? You're going to have to calculate them into existence.
My school shouldn't tell me.
Boys will be boys. Say no to sex because I don't feel like it's insulting. That a headache is a cop out. Menstruating a clever excuse.
And his sense a slight inconvenience, but it's not.
Because my body is a temple. And you worship at my altar with my consent. So if I say I don't want to, it means
I don't want to.
My body is my temple.
So you don't get to tell me who is or isn't allowed to enter.
You never taught me that sex should feel good. Never said that it's anything between more than a man and a woman. You said the words oral sex like they would burn you.
Like they were swear words. Not just another few syllables to describe what consenting individuals can do together. You never taught me that it was okay to not want sex.
You know that talking is hard. But sitting across the kitchen table, or standing in front of a classroom, or speaking from a podium,
and having a conversation about sex is uncomfortable.
But if you don't teach us,